What time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram. It's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Make sure to follow me there too. And it's time to get this movie for review started. Alright y'all, Spirit Untamed, DreamWorks movie is coming exclusively to theaters tomorrow, June 4th. And it has a cast that you will recognize, like the voice cast. It has some Julianne Moore Julianne Moore? It has some Jake Gyllenhaal. And it's actually based off, you know, a Netflix series, which was kind of based off a movie back in 2002 called Spirit, the Stallions of the Chimirana, I think that's how you say it. And what that movie was actually, you know, had some Oscar nominations, the original. So let me tell you a little bit first about what this movie's about. So unlike the original movie, Spirit, which, you know, was based, it was all in the perspective of like Spirit the horse, this one is actually comes from the perspective of a little girl named Lucy Prescott, and she lost her mother at a very young age. Horse accident. Like, you know, she was like this horse rider and everything. She lost her mother and as like a baby, and she was off to like kind of live with her aunt, you know, raise her. But now she's coming back to the summer where her dad is and spending time with him. While she's staying at the summer with her dad, who is the voice of Jake Gyllenhaal voices, she, you know, befriends a horse named Spirit, and it's a wild horse. It was a Untamed Spirit. That's where the name comes from. And she befriends him, who actually they're trying to get these poachers. These horse kind of poacher guys are trying to kidnap him, Spirit. And she's there to save the day. And it's kind of like looking at her perspective, kind of a coming of age story. And an unlikely friendship between her and the horse. So like I said, Spirit Untamed in the perspective of the little girl named Lucky, right? And which is not technically the sequel to that first Spirit movie, which was just in the horse's perspective, but it is pretty much a, you know, a loosely based sequel. Lucky, the little girl Lucky, is voiced by Isabel Merced. She's actually best known as Dora and Dora in Velocity of Gold, if you've ever seen that. So you may recognize her voice from that. I thought she did wonderful as Lucky. I did. I thought, you know, she had the spirit, you know, the energy. She had the little oomph, and I don't know, you know, the music I really liked, which I was like, is that her singing or someone else? Because I thought whoever sang, you know, a lot of the songs for her did a great job. I have to go back and look if that was her, because I enjoyed it. The other cast was great too. I mean, you have Julianne Moore, who plays her Aunt Cor. Julianne Moore's in everything these days, ain't she? And then you have Marcy Martin. She's best known as Dolly in Blackish. And McKenna Grace, whom you might know from, she was like in Captain Marvel as the young Carol. She was, you know, her, Grace and Martin were actually plays her friends on there, who kind of go off and teach her a lot about the horses. But, you know, were like her sidekicks in there. And like I said, you have Jake Gyllenhaal as playing her dad. That's what my first little complaint, because, I mean, Jake Gyllenhaal plays the dad. And granted, he didn't have a lot of screen time, but I felt like his character was kind of, you know, forgettable. That's how I was like, why even, they probably paid him a lot of money for this. Why'd they even do that? Because he wasn't in this much. His character's kind of forgettable. And then even when he did, he just seemed to kind of lack energy. I don't think he really wanted to do this. I think, I'm going to get in trouble. But I think he kind of just wanted a payday from this, because he didn't seem that into the character much to me. He did. Then the Jake Gyllenhaal's, my other big complaint was the animation. Now, let me explain. Because the first movie, The Spirit, was a 2D animation, right? And that has its charm. It does. I mean, it's not 3D quality it is now, but it's still the 2D. If you go back to it, has the charm. Well, this one, they wanted to go with the 3D. All right, so if you want to go with that, you got to at least try. You got to at least try to make it beautiful. But it looked cheap. I'm telling you, that was my biggest complaint in this movie, was the animation. There were scenes, I'm telling you, that, you know, they showed them riding the horses in these beautiful mountain sceneries, and them coming up on the horses and looking over the mountains with the sunsets. And all I can think about was, that would look really beautiful if they did the animation well, which they didn't. I was like, for a movie about, you know, literally the movie's named after Spirit, the horse. The horses didn't even hardly have fur on them. I was like, y'all gotta put a little something into this. Y'all could have took Jake Gyllenhaal out, saved that money there, and then put it into animation. That would have made it perfect for me. Despite the flaws, I'm gonna tell you, I did love the story. I did. I almost cried in some parts. It was touching. I mean, it's not for everyone. This is very much a kid-friendly, wholesome movie. It's very much for the kids and the young ones. They're gonna love it. They're not gonna nitpick like I do with the animation and all that stuff. And, you know, this is exclusively in theaters. So this is like a great one to bring the kids back, you know, to the movies, get them into that movie life once again now that we're all getting back to normal. It's one they're gonna enjoy. And you don't really have to worry about much of like mature content, you know, which... Let's talk about that. Let's see what, let me tell you what the parents need to know as far as, you know, parents guide before they bring their kids to see this. As far as language, so mild. I mean, so mild. This is a wholesome movie. The strongest word you're going to get is ones when they're, you know, they might call someone dimwit or even say heck. They might say heck, not even like the hell or anything. Heck. So extremely mild language. You don't have to even worry about profanity, none of it. Other mature content, I mean, you have the death of a mother. I mean, that's always hard and can be triggering for some kids, so that's always a lookout. Although you see that regularly in Disney movies, don't you? And, you know, these horses are kind of being poached and stolen by bad guys. So you're going to kind of see a little animal cruelty, I guess. You know, them pulling the horses, trapping them. I'm not sure if they, like, whipped them or anything, but they were very cruel to them. And, you know, so that could be triggering, you know, for some, the animal and the animal. Like I said, this isn't for everyone. This one is not going to be for everyone, but it's for the, you know, those parents that want to bring their kids back to a safe movie to the theaters that the kids will enjoy. They will undoubtedly enjoy this one. Kids will love it. Parents, I think, won't hate it. they won't hate it. I enjoyed it. Like I said, I thought it was a sweet story. And especially ones, you know, with a father-daughter kind of bond, I think this might be one that they might enjoy. Fathers can take the kids to see this one. So if you've seen it, let me know what you think. Comments, thumbs, and all that down below. And until next time. Mwah.